time and place. We will come back to the time and place when we taste, but we insist on that element. I don't know what is your perception of American wines, what is your perception of Napa wines, but I can hear very often that people say there is not real influence of the vintage, or even say sometimes there is no influence of the vineyard itself. And we are really pushing as much as we can to respect the time and the place. The time is the vintage and the place is the terroir. And you will see today with four vintages that there is a big difference between each vintage. That was a draw done by Michael Silacci, our winemaker, explaining that we try to get 80% of fresh fruit when we are picking Opus One, and 20% of ripe fruit, and we never go to overripe. I can tell you that some wineries, I don't say most, but some, are on the reverse. We are mostly picking sometimes 2 weeks in advance to some of our neighbors because we want to keep the freshness of the wine. And it's a challenge. It's always a challenge. We don't say it's better, we say it's our decision. It's a challenge because we have to be sure we have the right maturity, we have to be sure we have the right acidity, but not too much, the right equilibrium. And we want to get freshness and at the same time power. And you will see, especially with the 9 and the 10, the results we can get. Two important keys to know about Opus One, to know about Napa, but Opus One especially. One, irrigation. We are allowed to do irrigation, which is not allowed in France. But if we were not doing irrigation, it would be very difficult to do fine wines. Because the weather, especially during the summer, during the autumn, the September, October, can be very, very warm. So this is, but then there is a control of the irrigation. Not to irrigate too much. Because if you irrigate too much, the vine became lazy. The roots are not going deep enough, they are not taking the key elements in the soil. So you have to irrigate, but not too much. And I know that, I think it was a vintage 2008, Michael decided to really nearly no irrigate that year because he thought we have to stress the vine at that time. So it's always a question of equilibrium. The second decision is to harvest during the night. We do a big part of our harvest during 3 to 5 in the morning. There's 3 to 6 in the morning. When is the coolest time to get the more freshness? So it's a big when we have a very good team to do that. That's another picture taken during the... Then all the process will be exactly the same as a Grand Cru classic. If you go in Bordeaux, if you go at Opus One, it's the same thing. We pick everything by hand, we do the selection by hand, we have all the top machines to do the selection, optical trees, etc. We have everything. The cellar is also the same. We use 100% of new barrels, only French oak. We have 12 different coopers. It's exactly the same process. Aging is about 18 months, but you've got all the data in your brochure. So that's another picture. And those are a few pictures of Opus One. And also, just to show you inside, because we have also a beautiful place where we can welcome people. We have more than 60,000 visitors every year. It's only on request. It's and it's not free. You have to pay to visit. And Napa, I heard, is the second place in the U.S. for visiting, not Opus, Napa Valley, is the second place to be visited in Napa, in the U.S. after Las Vegas. This is my office in Bordeaux. because we opened the office in Bordeaux 2 years ago. As I told you, we are distributed now by the négociant. So I am here based in Bordeaux to work very closely with those 22 négociants spreading the distribution of Opus One all around the world. And that gave me the chance to be with you today, with Vin Direct, to present you Opus One. So that was the presentation of Opus One. I'm